This is Robotnik is Sexy. And I'm at SakuraCon, and it's really loud, and I wonder if any of this is audible at all. And this is a battle video I had with Mike while waiting in line to get SakuraCon passes or whatever the hell.
Oh, yeah.
Nidoking. I switch into Hydreigon and take the flamethrower well. And he stays in, and I Draco Meteor, and that's all good. Into Gygas! And by the way, Mike and I did some Pokemon exchanging. He gave me a Speartomb who kicks so much ass, it's amazing. And the Speartomb, we both used the same Speartomb, and so that Speartomb is basically my MVP for the match. And they go out into Barney, but it's not really Barney. It's that guy, Zoroark. And Zoroark sucks. And I lower accuracy, which is great. And for some reason, I want to save Zoroark for later, and he pursuit kills me. I swear, my Zoroark has like zero IVs in defense, because he cannot take a hit. Ever. Go into Togekiss, who is quite good. This Togekiss is Choice Scarf with max HP and special attack. I predict the switch into something fast, and I go for a Thunder Wave, which pays out really well.
I didn't die first, though.
Oh, good job, Michael! Switch into Jim Henson to take another special hit, which I do quite well. Actually, not well at all. I have one hit point. But yeah, that really sucks for him. I lived on one hit point. Switches into Gygas. I guess he didn't want... Like, this is probably the worst move he did, is letting his Gygas go down when he could have Shadow Sneaked, killed me or something. With a free switch in if I fainted his Jack-O-Lantern guy. So I finish off. Speartomb is amazing. And for some reason I stay in with this guy. Like, I don't know why. I should have gone to Speartomb. Because then Fake Out wouldn't work. Going to Dat Togekiss, and at this point he does not know I am Scarfed.
I will buy it.
So that is a free kill with Air Slash, and that's amazing. Goes into Code Monkey, I just take the Fake Out, I got no problem with that. Since this guy is max HP, he can take a couple hits before going down, and the Fake Out doesn't really do that much. Goes into Free Hugs, who I Air Slash, but it's not going to do anything, really. So, I switch out Togekiss. I'm going to Gygas, who apparently this Gygas set was designed by, who's the guy, Mike?
I don't remember. I don't know.
Some YouTuber designed this Speartomb specifically for killing Reuniclus, because Reuniclus is really, really damn strong. And let me tell you, it works. Now, he has the same spirit tomb, so he knows what I'm trying to do.
You guys want me to get rid of the items beforehand?
What?
I can get rid of the parts beforehand if you guys want.
So he does
the parts from Zero Suit Thomas? Do you want me to get rid of them?
Tries to wall it.
No, no, that's fine. Just throw them if you want.
Actually has Shadow Ball, so it can damage me. And since this guy is max attack, its defenses are really not that high. But I get to KO it with Choice Banded Pursuit, which is really great. Goes into Code Monkey, who U-turns, and this is probably the best part. He U-turns, and I Pursuit. Because I'm choiced into it anyway. But I think Hydrian predicted my switch out and wanted to U-turn that guy, but I just kept him in. And I can live a U-turn, so that is great. And this guy... this guy is scarfed, so even though he's paralyzed, he can outspeed me. I didn't know he was scarfed. I mean, most Jack-O-Lantern...
thank you for ever saving my life.
Yep. Ghost things are, so... What? Now we're going to Real Barney and Earth Power. This is the Dream World Nido King with Sheer Force and Ice Beam Flamethrower, Thunderbolt, and Earth Power. He's really good, and that is the game. And, yeah.
Oh, fuck.
Got him in three. Two big spells.
And, yeah, that's pretty much it. See you all later in YouTube land.